What's up, everybody? Hunter Avalone here, and welcome back to 5 Minute Facts. Today, we're talking about raising the minimum wage. Recently, House and Senate Democrats have been pushing a bill called the Raise the Wage Act of 2021. This would raise the current federal minimum wage of $7.25 to $15 an hour incrementally over the course of 5 years. America hasn't increased its federal minimum wage since 2009. It would also eliminate the sub-minimum wage of $2.13 for tipped workers, which has been stagnant since 1991. As it turns out, a whopping 1.6 million workers with wages at or below the federal minimum wage made up 1.9% of all hourly paid workers in 2019. So before we get into the benefits and the detriments of raising the minimum wage, we should ask, why do we even have a minimum wage in the first place? The purpose of the minimum wage was to stabilize the post-depression economy and protect the workers in the labor force. The minimum wage was designed to create a minimum standard of living to protect the health and well-being of employees. Others have argued that the primary purpose was to aid the lowest paid of the nation's working population, those who lacked sufficient bargaining power to secure for themselves a minimum subsistence wage. So minimum wage was designed to protect the lower wage workers from unsustainable living conditions so that they too could pursue the American dream. It instituted a moral minimum value on a person's working hours, regardless of a person's skill level. If they give 40 hours of their time each week to a company, the company is necessitated to provide the minimum of a reasonable living wage. This concept, however, stalled when the minimum wage stopped being adjusted for inflation. Currently, workers who earn the federal minimum wage make about $7.25 an hour, and that is about 29% less per hour than their counterparts made 50 years ago after adjusting for inflation. This is quite interesting because despite receiving 29% less per hour, minimum wage workers' productivity has gone up significantly. From 1979 to 2018, net productivity rose 69.6%, while the hourly pay of typical workers essentially stagnated, increasing only 11.6% over 39 years after adjusting for inflation. This means that although Americans are working more productively than ever, the fruits of their labors have primarily accrued to those at the top and to corporate profits, especially in recent years. In fact, despite the GDP rising steadily, only the top 10% of earners saw an increase of their wages tracking with rates of productivity. The effect on workers of the stagnation of the minimum wage has been extensive. More than half of minimum wage workers say they have to work more than one job to make ends meet. While a single person with no dependents who works full-time on minimum wage is considered slightly above the poverty line, a minimum wage income falls below the poverty line by more than $2,000 for a two-person household, more than $6,000 for three people, and more than $11,000 for four. According to a 2017 Government Accountability Office study, roughly half of all single-parent families with the parent earning minimum wage were living in poverty in 2016. A majority of them had to rely on a variety of government aid programs to just get by. So would raising the minimum wage incrementally to $15 an hour really help? Well, according to the vast consensus of economists, the answer is yes. In a letter signed by 100 plus PhDs in the field, they wrote, "This policy would directly lift the wages of 28.1 million workers by 2024. Another 11.6 million workers whose wages are just above the new minimum would likely see a wage increase through spillover effect as employers adjust their internal wage scales. A $15 minimum wage by 2024 would result in $121 billion in higher wages for 39.7 million low-wage workers, which would also benefit their families and their communities. Since lower-paid workers spend a large share of their additional earnings, this injection of wages would modestly stimulate consumer demand, business activity, and job growth." This is not just conjecture, this is supported by the data. Extensive research has found that modest increases in the the minimum wage had little or no negative effects on the employment of low-wage workers. It seems as if the extensive benefits outweigh the cost of marginal increases in inflation as well as fewer hours. Let's look a little further into the potential costs of raising the minimum wage. The first would be inflation, or an increase of costs for the consumers. This would look like a company raising the wages to federal government standards and needing to raise the cost of the goods or services they provide to accommodate for that increase of expenditure. This theory, however, is a bit two-dimensional because a higher minimum wage can also be offset by heightened productivity by workers or trimming down a company's manpower. When we look at the historical data and study how an increase in minimum wage has affected inflation, the concern seems to be especially unfounded. According to a recent piece of economic research that examined the effect of prices on minimum wage increases in various states in the US from 1978 through 2015, found that a 10% increase in minimum wage only accounts for around a 0.36% increase in prices. The other common concern with raising the minimum wage would be the resulting unemployment or lower hours, for similar reasons as the inflation. According to the Congressional Budget Office, the $10 minimum wage would raise earnings for up to 3.5 million workers and have virtually no effect on employment. As the legislation proposed would be increasing the minimum wage incrementally, this is important as it shows small hikes in the minimum wage should also have negligible effects on employment. In the letter from the economists, they also address the concern, saying, since as many as 10% of the lowest wage workers leave or start jobs every month, any decrease in the number of full-time equivalent jobs will mean that some workers will take more time finding a new job or will work fewer hours. But many of these workers may still see their annual earnings rise because of the wage increase. The final concern is typically in reference to small businesses. While incrementally raising the minimum wage would likely have some effect on small businesses, it would also not be one-to-one, because productivity tends to go up as wages do. Personally, I believe an interesting solution to promoting small businesses would be allowing them to opt out of the minimum wage if they operate as a worker co-op. This way, the workers could be invested in the company and would reap the benefits of being a part owner if they temporarily settle for lower wages. In the end, however, incrementally increasing the minimum wage would be a net benefit to society and would help to boost the middle class. The top 10% should not be the only workers who reap the benefits of overall productivity. If the minimum wage is adjusted, workers would be more productive and enthusiastic, the economy would be boosted, and hundreds of thousands of people would be given a leg up on pursuing the American dream.